You want to build an AI app but are overwhelmed by everything coming out so fast. So you get yourself an open API key, write a little bit of Python code, run it, and you're like, that's it. It's crazy how companies like OpenAI can build a code interpreter and ChatGPT in like what seems like minutes, while new startups are constantly coming up with fresh inventions every 10 minutes. Hi, my name is Lewis, and I'm on a mission to inspire developers and tech enthusiasts. In today's video, I'm going to show you some open source AI tools that you can use as a programmer to make your next AI application. Let me know what libraries you think are incredible. LangChain. Now, we're going to start off this video with the big daddy himself, LangChain. If you're building an AI application, then LangChain should be the framework that you build on top of. You'll thank yourself later. LangChain is designed to assist you in developing applications that combine large language models with other sources of computation or knowledge. Okay, here's an easier way to explain it. We want AI models to use each other and talk to other data sources. Of course, this sounds extremely messy when you translate it into code. So LangChain provides an easy-to-use API to optimize your prompts, create chains, so the result of one text generation influences the next generation, etc., storing your data to use in the AI, and then most recently, agents. A lot of the tools I'll be discussing in this video often integrate easily within LangChain, so make sure you start off here. So here are some awesome features with LangChain that I love. Prompt templates let you put in a template tag and a prompt in order for it to replace it when it says something. I mean, this is pretty cool, but it's not incredible. Output parsers formats the output of your text generation to the specific format. Imagine you wanted some parse as JSON and only JSON. Beforehand, you had to like make threats to ChatGPT, like give me JSON and only JSON. I will die if you do not give me JSON. With this though, you can confidently get the response you're looking for, which is essential if you're using LangChain to generate data that will match your API. And with chains, think of it like building a factory. You're building conveyor belts to each process. Place your input at the beginning and it goes into each process, which I guess you can kind of explain programming that way too. LangChain is more than incredible. It's almost necessary for your app, but let's move on. LlamaIndex. Now, large language models is an incredible tool when you think of it in the context of replacing a Google search or something. But what if you wanted to know how your Aunt Becky would respond to a meme that you would show her? Using your own data with AI is almost the first thing anyone thinks about doing. LlamaIndex is an open source data framework library used to help you connect all your data sources to your AI application. It also structures this data so that it's easy for an AI to parse it. Now, this is also a really big library, kind of like LangChain. But let's get into it. One of the core features outside of the data connectors is the data indexing. There are many ways to index your data, like list index. Think if you took a document, split it into three, and made them all line up with each other. Vector store, which embeds your text. Think of that like turning the data into numbers that is then put into a database. Tree index that lets you structure the data in a tree-like structure. Or a keyword table index. It's a massive library that you can do a whole video specifically about LlamaIndex. But when it comes to getting your own data and putting it into these large language models, then LlamaIndex is it's basically a must. Here's some examples that you can get your data from. So Llama Hub has a list of connectors you can use right away that has things like Gmail, Google Calendar, Twitter, Airtable. And because it's all open source, you can actually submit your own connector that you think other people would use as well. So it's an infinitely growing database of data. Something that AI shouldn't interfere with yet is authentication. But thanks to today's sponsor, Descope, authentication is extremely easy to implement. Descope is an authentication and user management platform that helps developers create secure authentication flows for your user interactions, using all sorts of different authentication methods like single sign-on, social login, one-time passwords, authenticator apps, magic links, passkeys and biometrics, and more is available there for you to use or whatever requirements you have. Implementation is also simple. You can use Flows, which is a no-code based editor to create and to see visually how your authentication flow works from beginning to end. Or if you're too cool for that kind of stuff, they also have APIs and SDKs for your front end and back end that is supported in Go, Node.js, Python, Flutter, and more. From the authentication flows to how the sign up and sign in screens are designed, the amount of customization available at your fingertips makes Descope an obvious choice. If you're building an AI app with any of the tools in this video, then getting your app to market fast is really crucial. Descope also succeeds when you succeed, with a very generous free forever tier that includes up to 7,500 monthly active users, 50 tenants, and no watermark. With Descope's commitment to open source and extremely easy implementation, it's a no-brainer. Thanks again to Descope for sponsoring part of this video. Click the link in the description to find out how you can add secure and frictionless login to your apps. Gradio. Now, when you're building your AI application, doing it through the command line will only really get you so far. But having to go through a whole UI development phase just also sounds like a complete nightmare, to be honest. Gradio is a Python framework for building UI for your machine learning applications. So instead of learning or just straight up writing a web app, you just write a little bit of Python code instead. And Gradio does all the heavy lifting for you. Think for a second how an AI application would work. Well, similar to other applications. You have things like dropdowns, text inputs, charts, images, videos, even 3D model viewers. And as of this video too, they released a new feature called Blocks that gives a lower level API that lets you customize it more to a web application, all still in Python. I know, it seems so silly to go on and on about what is so seemingly simple in programming. Text inputs, inputs, windows. But being able to rapidly create a user interface is what really makes a difference if you plan on showing your friends, cousins, your mom, rather than another developer with a README that you have to look into and do your troubleshooting with. So when serving your application, you can do it through a local tunnel to your device that it has provided. But that means you always have to have your computer on. But you also can deploy to something like Hugging Face for other people to see as well. A fun little extra too is GradioTools, which lets you put GradioTools that already exist on Hugging Face and elsewhere into your application. So if you wanted to grab a demo from the internet and make that a process in your LangChain, well, here it is. Gorilla. Now, if you're looking for something a little bit more intelligent, then you gotta give Gorilla a try. Gorilla lets your large language models interact with different tools through APIs. These APIs are tools that Gorilla is trained on to give you the best output to the question you give. So for example, if you wrote, I want to build a robot that can detect objects in an image, it will give you the APIs and tools you'll need to use in order to create it. Now, this tool is very early in development, so I'm just gonna briefly talk about it. What I like is that developers specify the low amount of hallucinations that the response brings. This gives much more accurate responses. Now, of course, Gorilla is very early in development and is still training on a ton of more data sets. But what I love about this project is the ambition it has for agents, we'll talk about that later, to intelligently talk to each API that it knows about. Right now, I believe it's trained on over 1,600 different APIs, but imagine if that eventually goes to millions or something. It's a very cool project. Make sure you check it out. LangFlow. Now, remember when I talked about Gradio for building user interfaces for your AI applications? Well, what if we can use a node-based editor to create the whole LangChain flow from the get-go? LangFlow does exactly this. It provides a no-code node editor. No-code node editor, say that three times fast. So you can create your language chains. It's built using the React Flow library, which if you're a web developer, you know that this is a really slick tool. It also provides a cool little chat bubble where you can test your AI on the spot. So it makes it easy for you to go back and forth in the development cycle. Now, would I use this for something serious? Probably not. Node-based editors are really powerful stuff, but when we create a level above LangChain, that means we have to wait for the developer of this to update the user interfaces. Also, being in an integrated development environment makes it easy for you to do things in Python or whatever language you're using separately from the LangChain itself. But there are spots you can put Python code in, but I would rather stay in the code editor. But that being said too, you're also able to call this chain through your existing Python code, so it does make it pretty flexible in that way. So if you're already building an application and you want to connect it to this, you can do that in your Python code. It's pretty sick. Overall, I just really like working with the code. But if you really need to prototype something fast or you just want to use this for a visual purpose, then this is actually a really cool tool. Agents. Now, this last part is going to be a little bit more broad, considering there's an entire ecosystem just based on this subject alone, and that's agents. An agent is an AI that executes tasks in order to come up with relevant answers or outcomes. If you're a ChatGPT Plus user, like myself, then you've already seen agents in action. For example, you can use GPT-4 with the Bing browser so that it can look up answers for you, or use the code interpreter for it to generate and execute code for you. As you can tell, much more advanced than just responding with text generations. In LangChain, there's already a huge amount of features just dedicated to building agents. So for example, you can ask the agent to do something. It'll go through the exact steps needed to be taken to figure out the answer of a question. So for example, who's Leonardo DiCaprio's girlfriend? What is her current age, raised to the 0.43 power. This is from the documentation, by the way. And you can see the agent try and figure it out to the action it needs to do, in this case search, to the observation it gets. This agent is then able to execute steps along the way until it finally gets to the answer. Agents do this through something called React, or reasoning and acting. For example, if you ask the AI the best way to get groceries based on an item, the location of the store, and time of day, the AI would need to reason about what the best route is to take and then plan out actions it would take to accomplish it. So yeah, this sounds pretty scary, but it works really well. Something that I seem to find lots of trouble finding is having agents create things for you. So for example, it would be nice to say, create an event tomorrow for Will and I to talk about video scripts. Right now, there really isn't much info on how LLMs can do this for you. And as of this video, it's hard to see tools that specifically interact with APIs, as in creating data and sending it on your behalf. Okay, so this video was recorded like less than a week ago. So Will, I need you to... OpenAI announced function calling, which is a new feature that the OpenAI API is capable of doing. What it does is that it detects when a user wants to do some sort of action. It will then look through functions that you've defined and create structured output that you define. You can then use this to call your APIs, your functions, whatever it is. So the way it works is that you call the model with functions and the user input. With the response of that, you call the API. Then with the response from the API, you give it to GPT-4 and it will summarize the information or do whatever you need. Now, this already kind of existed with LangChain with the routing and the output parsers that I mentioned earlier on in this video, but this really creates a brand new playing field when it comes to AI development. Seriously, AI development is going by so fast that I had to like stop production of this video. So hope you're happy. LangChain has a Gmail toolkit that lets you draft emails so that when you ask for it to draft an email, you can see in your inbox. A lot of this will really depend on if you want to build your own toolkits or not. The current state of AI development. The amount of tools are overwhelming, and trust me, I could have made like a 50-minute long video just dedicated to the different tools. But I wanted to show you some really cool tools that you can use today to make some really awesome AI applications that can match things like ChatGPT or OpenAI. Something that I would really like to bring up with LangChain specifically is that their documentation for sure needs a little bit of work. Often I go on pages that are 90% code snippets, which I feel like needs a little bit more explaining. Also, if you haven't noticed, almost all of this is Python. So if you don't know Python, then you might be out of luck. Now, let's also be specific. You don't really need LangChain to do any of the stuff in this video. Most of the things that LangChain does for you, you can easily recreate. Also, security is something that is being questioned when it comes to LLM applications. When you have agents running on their own, they might leak some of your crucial data, like API keys or health information if that's what you're developing. Now is the best time to interact with different models, data, and frameworks. Thanks so much for watching today's video. Let me know what AI app you have planned or is in development. Also, let me know if you guys like these videos where I shout out different open source applications. I used to do it way back in the past, but it was actually pretty fun doing it. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe for more dev and tech content. Peace out, coders.